Welcome to a Bible reading of the book of Ecclesiasticus, of the book of Sirach, chapter 3. Hear me, your father, all children, and do thereafter, that ye may be saved. Yah has given the father honor over the children, and has confirmed the authority of the mother over the sons. Whoso honors his father makes an atonement for his sins, and he that honors his mother is as one that lays up a treasure. Whoso honors his father shall have joy of his own children, and when he makes his prayer, he shall be heard. That honors his father shall have a long life, and he that is obedient unto Yah shall be a comfort to his mother. He that fears Yah will honor his father and will do service unto his parents as to his masters. Honor thy father and mother, both in word and deed, and a blessing may come upon thee from them. For the blessing of the father establish the houses of children, but the curse of the mother roots out foundations. Glory not in the dishonor of thy father, for thy father's dishonor is no glory unto thee. For the glory of a man is from the honor of his father, and a mother in dishonor is a reproach to the children. My son, help thy father in his age, and grieve him not as long as he lives. And if his understanding fail, have patience with him, and despise him not when thou art in thy full strength. For the relieving of thy father shall not be forgotten, and instead of sins, it shall be added to build thee up. In the day of thine affliction, it shall be remembered. Thy sins also shall melt away, as the ice in the fair warm weather. He that forsakes his father is as a blasphemer, and he that angers his mother is course of Yah. My son, go on with thy business in meekness. So shalt thou be beloved of him that is approved. The greater you are, the more humble thyself, and thou shalt find favor before Yah. Many are in high place and of renown, but mysteries are revealed unto the meek. For the power of Yah is great, he is honored of the lowly. Seek not out the things that are too hard for thee, neither search the things that are above thy strength. But what is commanded thee, think thereupon with reverence. For it is not needful for thee to see with thine eyes the things that are in secret. Be not curious in unnecessary matters, for more things are shown unto thee than men understand. For many are deceived by their own vain opinion, and an evil suspicion has overthrown their judgment. Without eyes thou shalt want light. Profess not the knowledge, therefore, that thou hast not. A stubborn heart shall fare evil at the last, and he that loves danger shall perish therein. An obstinate heart shall be laden with sorrows, and the wicked man shall heap sin upon sin. In the punishment of the proud there is no remedy, for the plant of wickedness has taken root in him. The heart of the prudent will understand a parable, an unattentive ear is the desire of a wise man. Water will quench a flaming fire. An alms makes an atonement for sin. And he that requiteth good turns in mindful of that which may come hereafter. And when he falls, he shall find a stay. Hallelujah. Yah bless. Shalom, shalom, shalom.